Okay, so the correct answers are not because post can't return HTML. We've seen that post can return HTML. They can return our error page, for example. But reloading our success page doesn't resubmit the form. That's a nice benefit. To remove the form parameters from the URL, technically, if you had a GET request that submitted your form, and then you redirected when the form was valid, yeah, you can remove the form parameters from the URL. However, if you are submitting, you know, if you're sending data to the server with a GET request, you have not been paying attention to this lesson. So I'm not going to count this as correct. And finally, so we can have distinct pages for forms and success pages. This is also true. What I've been getting at is this nice behavior you can have where you have your forms, and you submit that form over and over, you post to it, and you keep getting that form over and over until it's valid. And then once it's valid, we bounce the user, we redirect the user to another page, which whether it's a permalink to the blog post they just entered or to a thank you for being so good at entering dates page, you know, to thanks for registering on our website page. There's lots of things you want to do there. But having separate pages for those is nice. It's a nice way to structure our app. So let's go ahead and make this change to the app we've been working on.